Hi guys, today I'm going to give you one trading guide. It's not about any strategy I'm going to discuss, but a lot of you guys are making mistake while applying the strategy. So you should have a particular guide. So without wasting any time, I'll directly jump into what exactly I'm going to give you today. The trading determination means you should determine your trade early in the market. You cannot control your market, guys, right? Once you enter into trade, there is stop loss, there is a target. Either your stop loss get hit or your target get hit and you will come out of your trade. That is the only possibility can happen. So why you are looking at the market for the whole day? That is what my question is. You have to plan your trade early. This is your entry. This is your stop loss and this is your target and forget for the day, right? So there should be a determination. Second thing is sell volatility. Many of you guys are buying on the volatility. When market is going up and up, you are buying on the volatility. But when market goes at peak of the volatility, you have to sell at that point. How? We will come to know. We will show you how to sell a volatility. Basically, option trader, keep this point in mind, right? Trade breakout, guys. You have to identify what is a true breakout and when I can enter. Pocket in your profit early when breakout happens and follow your system diligently. If you are confused to how to identify breakout, you can watch my previous video wherein I have explained what is a true breakout and what is a false breakout. So once you identified what is a true breakout, you have to put your entry, and when your system shows that this is a crossover, you have to immediately book your profit. What I am trying to tell you here is don't trade on reversal of the market, right? Whatever system you may be following, don't trade on the reversal on the market. Trade on the breakout and trade on that entry, right? Enter late when direction is confirmed. What I mean by that? Many of you guys are jumping into the market in first 15 minutes, 30 minutes, 1 hour, or say 2 hours, right? Without knowing the direction of that particular stock or commodity. So you have to wait for direction to form. Every stock has particular direction for that particular day. I'm talking about intraday, guys. So don't jump into market or that particular stock without knowing the direction of that particular stock. You have to wait when the downward direction has formed. You have to wait for breakout in that particular direction, and then only you can enter in that negative direction only. Suppose some particular stock has positive direction from 915 to 130, right? And it started getting reverse. So don't trade on that reversal. You have to catch that direction only, because that stock has decided for that particular day that it is going to go up, right? So you have to go in that moment only, that momentum only. You have to go and buy that stock only, not looking for a selling opportunity. So wait and then confirm the stock direction. Once stock direction is confirmed, then only you have to trade in that particular direction after the breakout. Now the questions are, early means when and how to plan, right? When to sell volatility, which breakout to trade, and how to confirm the direction. So I'll answer all these queries. Let's quickly jump on the chart. This is NSE side, guys, and when you click on live market on equity derivatives, you will get this option chain. It is 6th June. Everybody knows this, right? I'm not wasting time on how to find that. I'm directly jumping into what is that selling volatility mean, right? If you check this column, change in open interest and open interest, you have to find out the highest open interest and change in open interest were building up. This is the strike price where the change in open interest is highest, guys, and open interest is also high. So where change in open interest is highest, more than the open interest value, that is your stock, that is your, I mean to say, a strike price of your interest, right? Right? So you have to pick the strike price, a 12,000 put option. This is the 12,000 put option chart, guys. This is what has happened here. Now, at this point, you were not knowing that volatility will build up this much. Nobody knows. Your interest is to sell this volatility at this particular point and book your profit here. Now, how to identify when to sell? That is the question in your mind, right? You were not knowing that from this point or this particular point, this market will reverse, guys, right? Then you take the help of your technical analysis of support and resistances. This is the resistance, guys, right? This is the resistance point. You can put your selling entry here when market was here and volatility is building. You have checked your NSE chart is building up very rapidly. You have to put your sell entry here. This is the resistance point wherein market will reverse, right? So now some of you guys may ask that if it breaks out and goes further, then what? Agreed, guys. But volatility will respect the next resistance. That is here it is, right? That is here it is. Again, you can draw a trend line. You know, from your technical analysis, you can draw a trend line and confirm this, right? This is a trend line for this downward movement of the stock, and this is my support, guys. Okay, so this is my support line. Now, what this has done? This has broken out this trend line and gone up. So definitely, once volatility is built up very high, there is definitely going to be a reversal. It has to come into this range, right? One more thing you can do to identify is check your Bollinger Band, right? Check your Bollinger Band. This will give you fair enough idea where you can sell. See, it has completely parsed out, broken out this resistance. So it is definitely going to reverse. When the stock is trading somewhere here and Bollinger Band upper line was trading here, it has not gone like with respect to this stock price, right? If it would have gone like this, then definitely there is further movement was possible. But the upper Bollinger Band has remained here itself. So that means this particular volatility has to reverse. And you have sold it here, checking the resistance point here, right? So this is one more technique to sell volatility. Now, the next thing I will tell you how to late enter your stock, right? For that, I'm going to take an example of crude oil. Basically, this helps you in commodity trading, guys, because commodity will catch the momentum of their particular day direction. What I mean by that, crude oil or gold, zinc, all these commodities are traded internationally, guys. Whatever trade in the international market, that particular direction or that trade, they will show in the Indian market, right? So late enter means what? Late enter means what? Say, for example, this is the trade of the crude oil. I'm taking one particular day. Say, for example, this is 30th May, right? And this is a 5-minute chart, guys. Why to take a smaller time frame? To know the trend of that particular commodity, right? You have to identify the trend of that particular commodity, right? For that, I'm deliberately taking a smaller time frame. Now, what is happening over here? First few hours, this particular commodity has maintained a positive movement in the market, right? It has maintained the positive movement in the market. Now, this law has become a strong resistance, right? When this law has been broken, the stock or that this commodity will flow in that particular direction. So this moment was positive, right? After that, when this resistance has been broken, then this resistance has been broken at this particular moment, right? It has started moving down. So this resistance breakout is your entry point, guys. This resistance breakout. What would be your stop loss? Your stop loss would be somewhere here, the day high. Now, once this resistance has been broken, the stock may go reversal and it can hover somewhere here. But when this resistance has been broken, then only stock will go in a upward direction. That has not happened, right? So if I make this as a resistance and this is my resistance, right? I will get a downward trend, right? So I will go on sell here. Again, I will respect my technical analysis like RSI. Looking at the RSI of 60 and 40, right? I'll check here what RSI is doing at this particular point, right? It is below 40, right? So this is the right point to sell. Again, I'll check my ADX to check the strength of that particular trend, right? Now, at this particular moment, my ADX was 24, right? ADX was 24. So I confirm my trade at this selling by this resistance breakout, right? And RSI is going below 40. Again, my ADX is started above 20 line. Above 20 is always you can consider for that particular trade, right? So this is the selling point, guys. This was my stop loss and I started riding the trend for that particular trade. I enter very late, guys. See, I entered very late into the market to understand what is the trend it is following. Now the lower highs are getting formed. See, this high has not been broken by this high. If this high has been broken by this high, then market would have started in that, in this particular direction, right? So you have to wait, confirm the trade, and then only enter into the market, right? So you understood the what is selling volatility and confirming your breakout, as well as entering late into the market would be beneficial for you guys, right? So this is what about guiding your trade. I'm not going to show you any technique. There are a lot of system you may be follow. You can follow this RSI and ADX technique, because ADX will give you the strength, RSI will give you the momentum in that particular direction, and your support and resistances will show you when the breakout is happening and what will be your entry point. One more indicator you can use over here is parabolic SAR. This is parabolic SAR. It is a wonderful indicator. When this dots are coming closer, guys, to the price action, that is when you can expect the reversal, right? The dots are coming closer, you can expect the reversal. So this is one more indication you can keep on watching, that when the dots are remaining here, right? The dots are making their existence away from the price action, right? That means that particular trend is going to remain into the market. When the dots are coming closer to the price action, that is when you can book your position, right? Again, you have to keep an eye on your RSI and ADX. When ADX is strong, right? ADX is strong and RSI is again going above 60, then only you can go on a buy side. When ADX is strong, what is indicating? The downtrend is strong, and that is what has happened. The ADX was strong over here, right? Above 70, right? That means this downtrend is strong. So though your PSR is coming closure, you cannot confirm that it will go reverse. See, that is what has happened. It has gone reverse, but being ADX is very strong, it has ultimately fall down. And that is what the overall direction of the market, that is what it has respected. That's what I'm saying. You have to understand the trend for that particular day. Once it has been broken out, you have to follow that direction. So here, if I would have entered in a buy direction, that would be the mistake. Only looking at the PSR. My overall direction was negative. My ADX was strong. So definitely it will go and break this level. So enter late in the market, guys, but understand the overall trend of that particular stock or that commodity. Then only your trade would be confirmed. Your decision would be confirmed, right? So that's it for now, guys. Hope this helps to you. If you have any queries, you can mail us or contact us. Definitely, we will explain everything what you want for the stock market learning, right? Thank you very much, and thanks a lot.